What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose you are given an array of meeting time intervals consisting of start and end times like the one you see in front of you. Then you are asked to determine if a person could attend all the meetings listed in these intervals or not. Now, a person can attend all meetings if there is no overlap between any meetings, right? As an example, take these intervals. You see, if we attempt to represent them in a graph, you will notice that the second and third meeting overlap, as well as the fourth and fifth, making it impossible to attend all the meetings. However, in the second example, because no overlap exists, a person will be able to attend all the meetings. Now, while visualizing the problem, you may have realized the solution is to return true, meaning we will be able to attend the meetings if the intervals do not overlap, and false if they do. But given two intervals, how do we determine if an overlap exists between them? Well, there are two ways to look at this. Either the upper bound of one of the intervals is included in the second, or the lower bound of one of them is included in the other. If this condition is true, then we have an overlap, right? So given the list of intervals, what we need to do is check if any of the bounds is included in any other interval. We could do that the hard way, by taking each one separately and looping over all the intervals and check this condition, or we could start by sorting the intervals by their lower bounds or start times to reach the state we've been dealing with since the beginning of the video. But how does that help? Well, take these intervals. Let's go ahead and sort them by their start time value. Notice how we just eliminated more than half of the comparisons we previously were talking about? Because instead of comparing each interval to all others, what we need to do now is check if the upper bound of an interval is included in the one following it only, just like we did in the initial examples. So, as mentioned, the comparison is now made between two adjacent intervals only. Meaning if an upper bound is bigger than a lower bound, or if an end time is bigger than a start time, then we have an overlap and we return false. To implement this, all we must do is sort the initial array by the start time as we discussed. Then for each provided interval now sorted, we are going to compare the end time of the current interval we are at with the start time of the interval following it. If that value is bigger, then we have an overlap and we return false. If we go over all the intervals and no such case is encountered, then we have no overlap and we can return true. Now, after solving this problem, the interviewer might decide to scale things up and ask you to find the number of minimum meeting rooms required to make all the meetings provided happen. So in this case, if we have no overlap, we need one room, right? So we would expect in this case to have overlapping intervals, that is the point. But how do we find the minimum number of rooms required? Let's take a practical approach and suppose we have the meetings you see in front of you. Now, if we want to get inspired from the previous problem, probably the first thing we'd want to do is sort these intervals by start time. After doing that, let's take the first interval, assign it to a room, then check if the second meeting can go after this meeting is finished in the same room. Well, in this example, it can't because they overlap, so we will have to reserve an additional room for it. Let's keep going. The third can go after the first one as they do not overlap, right? The fourth after the second, and the last one will need a room of its own. We end up with three rooms, which is the correct answer. Well, what we just did is a very good solution to our problem, but how do we translate this into code? How do we simulate what is happening? To do that, we have to take note of two things we did without even paying attention to. First, while inserting new meetings into the room, all we needed was the end time of the already ongoing meetings. You see, we could have stored only the end times, and we would still have been able to reach three and determine the rooms we need, right? As soon as a meeting starts, we don't care anymore about its starting time. All we care about is its end time. The second thing we were doing was look at the smallest end time we have between the rooms, because that is the only comparison we need to make. Take the fourth interval in our example. This interval was assigned to the second room. Why? Well, because that room will be free before the other ones. Additionally, because the intervals are sorted, we know that if that minimum value introduces an overlap with the current interval, then all others will, and we will have to reserve an extra room for it. Okay, to implement this solution, all we must do is start by sorting the list of intervals we have by start time. For this implementation, I went ahead and leveraged OOP to give you a slightly different approach to writing it, but you can easily convert it back to an array of integers like before if you feel more comfortable with that. Then to represent the end time values and be able to retrieve the smallest one efficiently, you guessed it, we are going to go with the minimum heap in its priority queue implementation. Next, while looping over the intervals, we will check if this queue is not empty and if the current interval's start time is bigger than the minimum end time stored in the queue. Then we are going to poll that value and store in its place the end value of the interval at hand because that is when this room will now be freed. If not, we will need to store the end value anyway as this will mean reserving a new room. We can extract the common add logic outside the if condition into the code you see in front of you. After the loop ends, the number of rooms reserved, which is the answer we are looking for, will be the size of the queue. And that's it. The link to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.